secret sin. Now, if we go to Proverbs chapter 28, verse 12. Proverbs 28, verse 12 says, Proverbs 28, verse 13. He who covers his sin will not prosper, but whoever confesses and forsakes them will have mercy.
Amen.
He who covers his sins,
amen,
shall not prosper.
Yeah, praise God.
But whoever confesses and forsakes them will have mercy.
Amen.
Now, on the today I'm also about to to unveil some secrets as well. I can't help it. That's that's the calling of the Lord. You know. So on the 3rd of February 2013, actually it was last year, at around 12:40 a.m. I was in this I saw this mighty revelation, and it's about people in different groups, in different stages, right? They were in about four stages. There were about four stages of people, about four groups of people. One group is the group that are still sitting, that are stagnant. Okay, this group is stagnant; they are doing nothing, right? The next group is the group of people that are already walking; they are already moving about; they are already walking. And the third group is the group of people that are running, okay? And the last one is the group of people that are already flying, all right? So, stagnant, walking, running, and then flying. It's just like an airplane, right? On the runway. At first, the airplane is grounded, right? And then the next stage of the airplane is it starts moving slowly, right? It starts moving slowly to the track, right? And then the third stage is it starts running fast, isn't it? Yeah. And when the plane runs, when it gets up to 160 to 180 miles an hour, it takes off, right? It starts flying. So this is the way the revelation went. And one thing I noticed, one thing that baffled me in this revelation is this: whenever anybody attempts to walk or to even run, Satan is there to break the person down. Whenever somebody attempts to walk or attempts to run, actually those that are walking, he doesn't really disturb them much. But those that are attempting to run, immediately he stops them. He wouldn't even allow them to walk, to run. You understand? I don't think he has much problem with those that are walking, because they are not getting far. But the moment you get to the stage of running, he's there to bring you down. Right? So people, we are getting frustrated because they are supposed to advance in their spiritual walk. It's just like Christians, you are supposed to advance in your spiritual walk, but then the devil is present to stop you. You understand? So this reminds me of the parable of the sower, right? Who sows in the stony ground? First of all, in the wayside, in the stony ground, on the nice stony or the rocky ground, and then among thorns, and then on a good ground. So now, when it came to me, right, I was already on the running stage. I was just about to fly. And then each time I attempted to fly, Satan comes in and he stops me. Each time I attempted to fly, Satan just comes in from nowhere and he stops me. And the funny thing is that whenever he stops me, there's one thing he always says. He always says this to me, that he has the right to stop me. Each time I attempt to fly, he comes in and he pulls me down. And I'll be so frustrated and angry, and I will try to start all over again, you know. But I tried to start again for the second time, and he was there as well. Then he pulled me down. So it just that I was very frustrated. It was just like the frustration of a man who's trying to build a house. You know, he spent all his time trying to build a house, and after completing the house, he's about to put the roof in the house, and the house collapsed. Right? Imagine how frustrated that person would be, and then the house collapsed because of a faulty foundation. Imagine how frustrated that man would be. That's the kind of frustration I felt when he pulled me down the second time. And I attempted to fly again the third time. He also pulled me down. And this time around, I was very angry, very, very frustrated. And in my frustration, I took a towel. I took a dark brown towel. Dark brown, like this. This color, right? I took this towel and I threw it at Satan. As in, take what belongs to you. Because of this towel, because this is your property. That is why you were able to bring me down. That is why you had the right to pull me down. Because I had what belongs to you. Right? So now, what then is the purpose of this revelation? First of all, if God chose you a revelation, right, it has to be scriptural. Right? You have to find it in the Bible. Now, in Revelation 12 verse 10, the Bible calls Satan the accuser of brethren. In John 10 verse 10, it calls him the thief that comes in to steal and to kill and to destroy. 1 Peter 5 verse 8 calls him the roaring lion seeking for whom to devour. 2 Timothy 3 verse 8, Apostle Paul talks about Jannes and Jambres, the agents of Satan who resisted Moses. So the devil goes into places where he can find something, anything that belongs to him. When he finds anything in your possession that belongs to him, that gives him the legal right to come in and stop you. Right? So why a tower? Why did I have to give him back this tower? Why a towel? Right? We all know that towel is this. Towel is something that you use in the secret, right? Okay? Towel. Do you tie towel around you when you go into the shop? No? You only use the towel in a secret place, isn't it? In the secret, right? In the bathroom, right? That's where you use your towel. Okay. So imagine a date, imagine the color, the dark brown color of a towel, right? What is the color? This is the color of death, isn't it? Dark brown, right? The color of death, isn't it? So a dark brown tower, a dark little secret, isn't it? So I had a secret. There was a sin, a secret sin that kept the devil, that kept me from advancing, that gave the devil the legal right to come in and try to stop me. When I tried to fly, when I attempted to fly, I was walking right in my spiritual walk. You understand? I first of all gave my life to Christ. I was walking, I started running, I advanced from the stage of walking now to the stage of running, right? And the moment I attempted to fly, when you fly, flying is the highest level, is the highest, the highest rate that you can, it can attain in the spiritual realm. So when I attempted to fly, he was there to stop me. In fact, people who are attempting to run, he will even go there and try to stop people who are attempting to run. But I was already on the stage of flying, right? But because I had this dirty little secret, I was not able to advance. Even though I had already given my life to Christ, even though I was already a Christian, I was already a believing, a very strong Christian, I was already moving with the Lord, but there was something within me that I have not yet confessed. Because the Bible says that he who confesses his sins and forsakes them will have mercy. He who covers his sin will not prosper. He who covers it. So when you come to the Lord, when you give your life to Christ, there are some things, it's called restitution. There are some things you have to go back and restitute. For instance, Brother Bambus told me about a story. I don't know if I'm allowed to say it here. You know, he used to have an affair in the past. You know, before he got married, he had a little child out of wedlock, and his wife didn't know about it. But the moment he became a Christian, he became a born again Christian. He went to his wife and he confessed that to his wife. He thought his wife was going to divorce him, but his wife didn't, because that was a burden in his heart. Now he knows that he has given his life to Christ. He could have easily asked the Lord, "Oh, please forgive me, Lord." And the Lord will forgive, but the Lord still requires you to go and confess that. You understand? Because that is your dirty little secret. And every time you try to advance in the spiritual realm, the devil will always be there present. He will always show up and he will stop you, because he has the right to stop you. You understand? So now I had this dirty little secret. This dirty little tower. You understand? Examples of these things could be, it could be lies, it could be deceit, it could be false prophets. You know, you're living a double life. Who you claim to be is not really what you are. You know, you come out in the public and you try to deceive people, you try to fool people. Whereas inside, you have a dirty little secret inside of you, and because of that secret, you will not advance. You know. Because of that secret, every time you try to make any significant effort, you know, to attain a glory, the devil will always be there present, because he has the right to be there, you know, to stop you. Now, a lot of some of the Christians, majority of the Christians have to falsify documents. They lie to social welfare to get money. they lie about insurance, they lie about a lot of things. But you see, lies, you know, will hinder us from making any progress in life. You know, lies, living a double life. We know that we are Christians, we have come to the Lord, but we have to confess some things. In lies that we told in the past, we have to restitute these things. You know, exaggerating claims with insurance to get more money. By so doing, one has opened the door to the enemy. You know, as it is here in Proverbs 28, verse 12. He who covers his sin will not prosper. And Psalm 90, verse 8, he says, you have placed our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence. And Psalm 139, verse 23 says, search me, O God, and know my heart. You know, search me and know my heart. Because God sees that little things that we do not see. That little things that we might hide it from other people. We might try to hide it from everyone else. You know, we might try to deceive the pastor, or to deceive the congregation, or to deceive the people. You know, when we get in front of the people, we put on a sanctimonious facade. Whereas deep inside, we know that there's something that is wrong. You know, but until we confess that to God and we forsake it, there's no way we're going to advance. You know, until I had to restore that thing, until I had to restitute that thing. You understand? I wasn't going to move any higher. You understand? So I had to do it. I had to restitute that thing that I did wrong in the past for me to be able to move higher. Otherwise, the devil would always be there. He would always show up. He would always come in the prayer. He would always stop you if you do not restitute that. You know? Now, what we have to do is, I'm just rushing this message because we have to go. Now, what we have to do is to give back to the enemy what belongs to him. That dirty little secret that we have in us. That lie that we have told in the past. That thing that we have done in the past. We have to go back and restitute. To free ourselves like gazelle. Otherwise, there's no way we're going to advance. Probamos, ever since you made that confession, what happens? You're a free man, isn't it? Uh-huh. We have to make that restitution. The Bible says in James chapter 4, verse 7, resist the devil and he will flee from you. Submit to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. And John 14, verse 30, for the ruler of this world is coming and has nothing on him, says Jesus Christ. If Satan had something on Jesus Christ, he would have been able to stop him from advancing in his work. But because Satan didn't have anything on him, he was able to carry out with his ministry unhindered, unrestricted, unstopped. Ephesians 4 verse 27 says, do not give the devil a foothold. Every door that you open, or every door that you have not closed from the past, the devil will exploit it. He will continue to exploit it. He will continue to exploit it until you close that door. And what causes us sometimes to, you know, what stops us sometimes from, you know, confessing our sins is because we are afraid of the consequences. What might happen? What's going to happen if I say this? What's going to happen if I go to that brother and say, back in the days, this is what I did? What's going to happen if I make a call? What's going to happen if I do this or do that? People are afraid, and as a result of that, they are not able to advance even in the spiritual realm. So I pray that the Lord will give us the ability to restitute, to make restitution, to give back to the enemy what belongs to him. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
When the pieces seem to shatter, gather off the floor, and all that seems to matter, that I don't feel you anymore. No, I don't feel you anymore. I need a reason to sing. I need a reason to sing. I need to know that you're still.